I'm Eric Kelly from KellyPlanet.com, and this is a closer look at Star Trek Lower Decks, Season 2, Episode 9, WEJ DUJ. First of all, obviously, the title is in Klingon, which is cool. You may have noticed I'm a bit of a Klingon language enthusiast ever since I got the Klingon dictionary when I was a kid. WEJ DUJ, since they never say those words in this episode, I'm basing my pronunciation on the TNG episode, The Chase, where Data and Nudok do the Bok Kul challenge. Nudok says, Wa cha wei. 1, 2, 3.
Wa cha wei.
So, WEJ DUJ translates to three ships. Oh, and those Klingon glyphs are correct. I looked them up. There's no opening sequence, so let's get right into it.
Engage.
The Cerritos is on its way to the Kantaran system to conduct a planetary survey. The trip is going to take a while, so Freeman has approved R&R for the crew until they get there.
I can't believe we all have the day off. What should we do? Stratagema tournament?
Stratagema was first seen in the TNG episode Peak Performance. I haven't pointed this out in a while, but they're all eating Mexican-inspired food, like normal. Rutherford and Mariner are, at least. Tendi has some kind of soup, and it looks like Boimler has white rice. Rutherford often has a purple frosted cupcake. And here we go with the premise of this episode, which is fun. While Boimler tries to buddy up with the command crew, we get to see what the lower decks is like on various ships. Starting with a Klingon bird of prey, Chata. Dude's filing his teeth. Ferengi do that too.
And, stationed at the captain's side, I will be the logical choice to be the new first officer.
Logical? Are you a Vulcan now?
Could you imagine serving with those Beknok?
Beknok is Klingon for coward. Yes, now the Vulcan cruiser, Shaval.
I have detected an anomalous surge of Metreon particles in system 7743.8.
I can't remember if Metreon particles appeared anywhere else, but that was a thing in Insurrection.
Remove this! I don't want that stench on my bridge.
So to impress Captain Dorg, oh yeah, that smaller dude's name is Ma, he gets rid of the body for him.
Right, Carno in the forest with Myra?
It is hard to lose weight when you can replicate any food you want.
In search for a bridge buddy, Boimler strikes out with Kayshan. That's an interesting pottery shape Shax has going there. Boimler mentions Bajor, which sets Shax off, so there's no bridge buddy here either.
Resisting fighting fascism is a full-time job!
He's not kidding!
He's talking about the Cardassian occupation of Bajor, which was going on until just before Sisko took command of DS9.
Yes, good boy! That is what we will do to enemy Patak.
That's a Targ, and Patak, which used to be spelled like this, back in TNG, they changed it for some reason, is a common Klingon insult, like to be weird.
Captain, your Targ is most impressive, like Kor's Hound at the Battle of Klaktikelbracht.
Okay, Kor is this guy, who was the first Klingon commander ever seen in the TOS episode Errand of Mercy. He was also in the animated series and as a Dahar master in Deep Space Nine. Klaktikelbracht is a famous battle between the Klingons and Romulans in 2271, mentioned in both DS9 and Enterprise.
Why would you modify already adequate long-range sensors when that is outside of your duties?
I had a gut feeling that increasing our sensor range may prove illuminating.
Man, Vulcan ships are dry. I mean, of course they are, but jeez. El Capitan in Yosemite National Park from Star Trek V, but in that case, it was Kirk doing the free climbing, Spock in the rocket boots, and McCoy was on the ground like a reasonable person. This is why rocket boots are so dangerous. Boimler tries Captain Freeman, but she and Mariner are arguing about lady issues, so he gets the heck out of there.
Mr. Boimler, are you also from Hawaii?
He has to be. Only people who grew up on the islands like us could describe it like that.
You're all from Hawaii.
Aloha. Yep, small galaxy, huh?
What are the chances that there would be three native Hawaiians on a starship with a crew of only 200?
Perhaps you could look to me as your confidant. In Klingon culture, they designate those who stand with one another as Chadich.
That's the third reference to Chadich in this series.
Just tell them you're not from Hawaii.
I tried, sort of.
Rutherford has his DS9 model from An Embarrassment of Duplers, the one I used to have.
We've lost our way.
The Empire still strikes terror. Klingon blood runs as reddish pink as ever.
Reddish pink blood? The most we see Klingon blood is in the Undiscovered Country, and it looked like Pepto-Bismol. This has not been consistent throughout the series.
It is troubling to see a proud cast of warriors lose their Lordesh.
Lordesh means tradition.
Oh, hi! Are you ready to give us present?
With the weapons and information I've armed them with, they've thrown the entire quadrant into discord.
So far on Lower Decks, the Pakleds have been the primary antagonists, which is kind of weird, except now we know at least a faction of the Klingon Empire has been providing them with weapons and intel.
Cry havoc and let slip the dogs of war!
That's a direct Shakespearean quote from General Chang in Undiscovered Country.
Cry havoc and let slip the dogs of war!
I think it was the chef in the biolab with the sniper rifle that can shoot through walls.
The sniper rifle that can shoot through walls came from that Ezri Dax episode of DS9.
We need another boomer.
What? No! One Viruvian bomb is enough!
The Pakleds were mining Viruvian ore in the episode Kayshan, His Eyes Open.
We already used it.
You used it? On what? Why?
We wanted to test it on a big asteroid, but then it stopped working.
It was a bomb! You can only use it once!
You can only use a bomb once. So the Cerritos gets into it with the Pakleds and that bird of prey. Oh yeah, the Aritos shirts are a reference to the disco shirts in Discovery. Since the crew was on R&R, there's Anbo Jitsu. That's from the TNG episode Cupid, when Picard was Robin Hood. And someone doing Data's Sherlock Holmes holoprogram, unless that's like the Hugh Hefner program.
I'm not from Hawaii.
Not from Hawaii either.
Neither am I.
Oh, I'm not from Hawaii.
Wait, what now?
I'm actually from the moon.
Wait, bro. Earth's moon? That's where I'm from!
I'm from the third moon of Benzar. We're all moon buddies?
You know, some people say Modesto is like the moon of San Francisco, so I guess I'm from a moon too.
Boimler admits he's not from Hawaii, and it turns out that the other three actually are not either. But they are all from moons. Boimler's from the moon of San Francisco.
Do not talk to me of honor! I've been crushing Pakta beneath my boots since before you were born!
I've never heard it pronounced Pakta before. It's supposed to be Patak. Hey, it's the Cheval. Awesome. The Vulcans are always doing cool stuff like this in Enterprise. So Ma'a kills the naughty Klingon captain and calls off the attack on the Federation ship since he's the captain now, because that's how things work on Klingon ships. The combined forces of the Cerritos and the Cheval drive the Pakleds away.
They're all from moons. Look at them. Probably talking about tides and werewolves. I was so close.
Tides and werewolves, that's freaking great. This is also great. They do the Lower Decks on a Borg cube, which, depending on how you look at it, they're all Lower Decks. And this is the first time they do a thing behind the end credits. If I had to pick on this episode, it would mostly be on me. Seriously. I like the looking at the Lower Decks on various ships angle, but I found it harder to write this episode. That may be because I did this while my 5-year-old nephew was visiting, and he makes me tired. The title of this episode is Three Ships, and I assume they are referring to the Cerritos, the Chita, and the Cheval. But we also looked at the Lower Decks of the Pakled Clump Ship and the Borg Cube 90182, which is a zip code in, you guessed it, Los Angeles. I think it's interesting that they are portraying Vulcan ships like they were in Enterprise. This show's timeline is post-TNG, and from what I gather from that show, all Federation ships are Federation ships. The Vulcans didn't have their own at that point because they're part of the Federation. There was lots of Klingon in this one, which I find fun. I did my best with pronunciation, and I'm pretty close. I also paid attention to my English translations as far as syntax and punctuation is concerned. Certain Klingon letters are meant to be capitalized and some are not. The people who wrote the closed captioning were certainly not aware of this. That was Star Trek Lower Decks, Season 2, Episode 9, WEJ DUJ. And I'm Eric Kelly from KellyPlanet.com. Live long and prosper.